Hi friends, please subscribe to Amravati Media and press the bell icon for more latest updates.
Thank you, Deputy Chairman, sir. I rise to support the motion moved by Sri Bhupendra Yadav ji and seconded by Sudhanshu Trivedi ji. Sir, it was the first address by the Honorable President of India to the Parliament after dawn of this new decade, 2020. The address was full of aspirations and quite clearly highlighted the government policies, priorities and plans for the upcoming year. Sir, the Honorable President has missed to assure the country and the Parliament that the government shall focus on better implementation of the laws that have been enacted by this Parliament. When I'm referring to the implementation of enactment of laws, I'm referring to the AP Reorganization Act, which has failed to live up to the expectations of the 5 crore people of Andhra Pradesh. Sir, I am asking from the government that the government should focus on economic situation and finances of the country, more particularly the states which are really backward and agricultural based states like Andhra Pradesh, as much as it does in the case of Jammu and Kashmir. I am not opposing the financial aid to Jammu and Kashmir or Karnataka or Telangana. I am only asking for Andhra Pradesh. Sir, I draw your kind attention to para 15 of the presidential address, which quotes Shyama Prasad Mukherjee and talks of parity of rights of the citizens between the states. When I see that the government, based on special needs of Jammu and Kashmir and other states of Ladakh, is giving extra finances this year and it does nothing in the case of Andhra Pradesh. Sir, when I see that President has assured speedy establishment of IIM and IIT in the case of Jammu and Kashmir, while IIM in Visakhapatnam is functioning out of temporary arrangement. Sir, I come to the special category status. My friend Jairam Ramesh ji claims that he claims himself to be the author of the special AP Reorganization Act. And I can say, sir, the special category status, which was promised by the then Prime Minister of this country, has not been given till date by the present government. Sir, yes, special category status is a condition, as my friend is aware, is a condition to pass AP Reorganization Act. The very process of AP bifurcation is predicated upon the assurance of special category status. Therefore, special category status is supplemental, incidental, and consequential to bifurcation. Sir, there is no mention of special category status in the presidential address. There is no mention of special category status when the terms of reference have been framed in the 14th Finance Commission. There is no reference about the special category status when the terms of reference have been drafted in 15th Finance Commission. Sir, the 14th Finance Commission, member of 14th Finance Commission chairman as well as the member, Sri Govind Rao and Sri Dr. Abhijit Sen, giving in writing saying that 14th Finance Commission did not recommend anything on SES, special category status. Whereas the ministers on various occasions, ministers of NDA, on various occasions claimed that 14th Finance Commission did not accept the special category status to the residuary state of Andhra Pradesh, which is quite misleading and not warranted. Sir, 15th Finance Commission did not recommend SES for AP when asked, when in fact I draw your kind attention to the report of the 15th Finance Commission, sir. 15th Finance Commission says, para 7.4, Sir, some states, I quote it, sir. Some states have requested the grant of special category status. This does not constitute part of the mandate of Finance Commission, 15th Finance Commission, and remains entirely in the domain of Union Government, remains entirely in the domain of Central Union Government, which can take appropriate decision after due considerations. Therefore, what I am trying to say, the ministers in NDA are misleading the Parliament by saying that the Finance Commission, 14th Finance Commission or 15th Commission, 15th Finance Commission did not accept for granting of special category status to the residuary state of Andhra Pradesh. I really don't understand why the UPA, which has enacted this law, is keeping quiet in this regard. We are only demanding implementation of Union Cabinet decision. Union Cabinet then, before the elections in the month of February 2014, taken a decision, and that special category status would be granted to the residuary state of Andhra Pradesh. Sir, coming to 15th Finance Commission, sir, last due to 15th Finance Commission. How stepmotherly treatment has been given to the residuary state of Andhra Pradesh? 15th Finance Commission submitted its report 1 week back, last week. What is the criteria it has followed? The criteria adopted by 15th Finance Commission, by virtue of the criteria, all southern states, whether it be Tamil Nadu or Karnataka or Andhra Pradesh or Telangana, all southern states, including AP, is losing because the criteria it has followed is population on the basis of 2011 census,
yes,
instead of 1971 census. Why is this injustice? Why a stepmotherly treatment towards the southern states of in this country? Sir, due to this, AP is losing, Andhra Pradesh is losing 1,521 crores, and it has fallen like a bolt from the blue on Andhra Pradesh. Sir, because of the weightage to AP has come down from but to 15% on population parameter, which resulted in 1,521 crores of loss. Penalizing on the performance. Why? Because Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka have strictly implemented the population control measures. Is it the sin that southern states have committed? So this question has to be answered, sir. Sir, 14th Finance Commission released the funds to the state of Andhra Pradesh at the rate of 4.3%, 4.305%, but 15th Finance Commission, because of this criteria, it has come down to 4.11% for the award period. It's an injustice that is meted to the Andhra Pradesh, sir. I demand that the special grant given to Telangana, Karnataka and other states, including Jammu and Kashmir, on the similar lines, AP also should be given the special grant, sir. Sir, the next point, sir. In fact, sir, CAG, Controller and Auditor General, has certified and approved the revenue deficit of Andhra Pradesh for 2014 and 15 to the extent of 16,075 crores, which central government has promised to reimburse, which has not been done, sir. If PRC arrears and deferred bills are also added to the 16,075 crores, then it comes to 22,948 crores. Government of India has given so far 3,979 crores. I request the Government of India and Honorable Prime Minister of the country to release the balance amount of 18,969 crores. Sir, coming to the Polavaram project, Government of Andhra Pradesh has so far spent about 11,860 crores on Polavaram. Government of India has given only 8,577 crores, and the balance amount of 3,283 crores is yet to be released. Sir, the revised DPR and cost estimation of 55,548 crores was approved by the Technical Advisory Committee, but pending before the Government of India, sir. Sir, very important aspect, sir, which my friend Jairam Ramesh ji also is aware of it. Package for backward districts. And my friend has proposed in the act itself that the backward districts of Andhra Pradesh, 7 districts, under the, this is under section 46 subsection 3 of the Reorganization Act, Government of India for special package should be given to the state of Andhra Pradesh for these 7 districts. Sir, what has been given so far is only 1,050 crores. But what has been promised? The package will be on the same similar lines of Bundelkhand, KBK district in Orissa, and Bundelkhand in UP and Madhya Pradesh. If the package on the similar lines is worked out too, it will come to 24,350 crores. Whereas the government of India has so far given 1,050 crores. So this is definitely an injustice that is meted out to the state of Andhra Pradesh, sir. When it comes to the industrial incentive, sir, government of India is saying that post GST, no industrial incentive would be given to any of the special category states. It is not correct, sir. Government of India is misleading. Sir, as per 2017 notification, 27,000 crores have been allotted to 4,324 units in special category states till sunset period of March 2027. Sir, in 2018, Commerce Ministry has approved Northeast Industrial Development Scheme with 3,000 crores. It is up to March 2020. Sir, last point.
Already
last
time
point.
Is over. There is one
coming
more
to the railway zone, sir. The railway zone has been incorporated. Yes, sir. Over, sir. Last point, sir. Railway zone has been promised in the AP Reorganization Act. With great difficulty and with lot of fighting, the railway minister has finally approved to create a separate zone for Visakhapatnam. Whereas the existing Visakhapatnam division has been dismantled, has proposed to be dismantled and then clubbed with the division of Vijayawada Guntur, sir. Sir, which is totally not acceptable to the state of Andhra Pradesh. The last point, sir, I'll not ask for any further time, sir. Vizag Chennai Industrial Corridor. Sir, this is very important. How injustice is being done. Sir, government of India has taken up Mumbai-Gurgaon Expressway connecting country to two most backward districts, Mewat in Haryana and Dahod in Gujarat. It costs about 60,000 crores. When the Vizag-Chennai Industrial Corridor is stipulated and enacted, included in the AP Reorganization Act, why government of India is not implementing it? When similar projects are being undertaken in the other parts of the country, why stepmotherly treatment to the state of Andhra Pradesh? I request the Andhra Pradesh, in conclusion, sir.
Please conclude, Vijay Sai Reddy ji.
Sir, I am concluding.
इस कैटेगरी में एक और स्पीकर हैं, सारा टाइम खत्म हो गया, आपने 2 मिनट अधिक और लिया, 8 मिनट की जगह आप लगभग 13 मिनट बोले हैं.
It's a conclusion.
It must be last line now.
Yes, sir. It's a conclusion, sir. Para 31 and 32 of the Honorable President talks about the striving hard for social, economic and educational progress of the minority communities. Therefore, I believe that it is also within the ambit of the Government of India to ensure that insecurity and insecurity in the minority community does not arise. And even if it does, it is the onus of the central government to
now.
Reach out them and clarify
not
their
going
doubts
on record
and
now.
Take them
Nothing
along
is going on record.